Hello and welcome to the 12th part of my LEGO Powered Up tutorial series that you can use for Powered Up, LEGO Boost and Control Plus. Today we'll go to the outside, or at least we'll try to mimic the outside, because we will try to mimic how lamps, or how fire, how moving light works, or flickering light. First you can try to come up with some solutions on your own. There are many ways to do that. Just try to imagine how fire moves when it's burning, how the light flickers, and how you could simulate that in the software. I hope that you do that, and we will visit the topic in several parts. Today we will use a very basic solution that has some disadvantages, but more on that later. I already connected the hub to the app. We have two blocks to control the lights of the hub. They are in this purple category. And here we have this block, and this block is for the lights. I use the normal powered up lights that you can get in the LEGO store for about 10 euros or $10. And it includes two lights which have the same brightness. But anyways, we have two different blocks to control the lights of the hub LED. With the first one, we can select a specific color, and with the second one, we can control the actual R, G, and B values. But I want to show you where the hub is, and for that, I will put the last light to 100%. The last percentage is blue. It's red, green, and blue, but the red and the green color aren't very bright, and it's a water cave, so blue actually makes sense. So let's try it out. There's a cave in the mountain. I use a LEGO City Jungle Explorer set. It's not available anymore, and I use it just for decoration. You can use the LEGO sets that you own, or you can build your own set. And let's look where the lights are. They can only shine in white, but we can put colored plates in front of them, and then they will shine in other colors. So I will turn them on with the full brightness. And now we can see them. One is in the plane here, one is in the other cave, one is in the fire, and one is at the lamp. But currently they only shine in one specific color, or in one specific brightness. They don't flicker. So let's try to make them flicker. The flickering of a light is always determined by the wind and other factors. It's pretty random, so we can also use a random number. And for that we have, with the white blocks, this block that allows us to create a random number between two other numbers. So this block creates a number between 1 and 10. The brightness can go from 0 to 100, and the hub LED is pretty dark, so we have to use higher values. In my case, I use a number between 50 and 100, and the normal LEDs are pretty bright, so we can select a color between something else, maybe 10 and 90. Of course, you can play around with the values. You don't have to stick to the values that I use. And you can think about it, and maybe you will find a better solution, but more on that later. And of course, we want them to flicker, so they should change their color rapidly. And to do that, we can use a loop. So simply place them in a loop. And now let's try it. So the program is working. It's flickering pretty much, so that's not really perfect. I would say that especially fire or stuff in lamp would be a bit slower in the flickering process. But I'd say that this is a first solution, and we can think about how we could improve that in the future. One thing that we can think about is that normally a bright fire won't turn dark in a snip. It will take a while to get darker and a while to get brighter. So we have to work with the last value and then change the new value accordingly. But we will look into that in the future or in a future part. Oh, and please tell me if you've got any questions, if you didn't understand something. You can already try to come up with your own solutions. Thanks for watching. See you in the next part, and bye.